Whether it's a large tree slicing into a home or heavy machines moving debris, few people were expecting all this.
A lot of people weren't prepared. A lot of people were.
The pile behind me is an example of just the amount of storm cleanup people have been doing. Tall piles of debris are lined up across many roadways around Lillian.
Roadways and power lines that are still down, so it does hinder rescue efforts. It also hinders traffic flow.
In addition to the mounds of junk and battered homes, many docks and piers along Perdido Bay were either obliterated or rearranged by Sally.
You live in Lillian, well, you know, sooner or later it's going to catch up with you.
Even homeowners relatively unscathed by the storm still had junk washing up in their yards.
It's bad around here. We were not expecting this size of a storm, or we would have not stayed.
Power crews trying to make it easier for people to stay in their homes now. People admire the sacrifice.
I talked to one of them yesterday, and they're working 18-hour days, and some of them are sleeping in their trucks.
Few resting well with the cleanup ahead. In Lillian, Chad Petrie, WKRG News 5.